Subject to the payment of my just debts and funeral and testamentary expenses, I give, devise, and bequeath all my effect and estates whatsoever, including any property over which I have a general power of appointment by will, to my trustees upon trust, to my two beloved sons, Kurt Ludwig Gutenberg and Gustav Otto Gutenberg, in equal shares absolutely, provided that if either of them shall predecease me, leaving a child, none of that last bit is relevant. You're both alive, and there are no grandchildren. Yet. So, couldn't be more straightforward. Everything split right down the middle. Oh, and then there was this.
What is it?
I have no idea. It's addressed to both of you.
Thank you.
My darling boys. By the time you are reading this, I will be gone. But I wanted you to know that you have both given me so much joy in my life. Not just watching you grow as individuals, but in the knowledge that you both have so much affection for each other. I think brotherly love is a truly wonderful thing. Do you remember when you were both little, how we would sit together in front of the fire on rainy evenings, and I would tell you stories? And when I had finished, you used to say, Papa, just one more. Well, I have one final story for you both. So why don't you pour yourself a beer? I think you are going to need it. It all began in 1939 on a little dairy farm in England. The farm was owned by Jacob Jackson and his wife, Margaret. They had two sons, Jake and Greg.
Funny day, isn't it? Jake, get down. I've told you before. Jake!
I said get down.
Just you wait till your father hears about this.
That's enough, Jacob.
Not so rough, Jake. You should learn to treat a lady properly.
I love that, thank you.
Come on.
I ain't going up there.
Come on. Suppose I'll just have to come down and get you then.
You could have killed yourself doing that.
But I didn't, did I?
Why didn't you have a go?
You don't want to do it. Because you ain't got the balls. That's why, eh? Have ya? You ain't got the balls to do it.
So where'd the bike come from, eh?
Borrowed it. Off a mate.
500. Vertical twin. Very sweet.
Triumph Tiger.
What mate might that be, eh? He says he borrowed it, Jacob.
Just for the day. It's Charlie Parmus. Giving it back tomorrow.
You're working here tomorrow, that's what you're doing. There's more than enough work to be done without you messing about with motorbikes that don't belong to you.
We're fixing the fortune tomorrow.
Magneto's not sparking.
Not when the two of us can't put right their way, Dad. Get rid of it, Jake.
We can eat it.
Get rid of it.
I know how to skin it. Dad showed me.
We'll see what your father has to say, shall we?
Just a kitten.
He took your gun.
Not enough meat on it to feed a sparrow, let alone a family of four. Sorry, old boy. Dogs will like it.
Thank you.
What do you want?
Well, go on. Have a look.
Stop it, Jake.
Oh, he's not interested in your tits, Sally. He's a homo.
You're not a homo, are you, Greg? Made you jump. Shouldn't take any notice of Jake. He's daft.
I don't take any notice of him.
I don't believe what he said about you. I know you like girls. I see you looking at me. They say there's going to be a war. What do you do if there's a war?
There might not be.
Of course there will. Everyone says it's going to happen. What will you do? Are you going to fight? They might call. That's what they do, ain't it? Come and get you. Make you sign up and all. If you go to war, you have to kill people. I don't think I could ever kill anyone, could you? There might not be a war. What were you reading just now?
Nothing.
That weren't nothing. I saw you reading. I like reading. Shakespeare's sonnets.
They're poems.
I know what a sonnet is. Shakespeare. He's good, he is.
He wrote plays as well.
Greg, I ain't stupid.
Sorry.
We used to have to learn poems in school. I like poetry. I was good at it. Not like sums and stuff. Could never write up to save my life. But poetry, the
makes everything matter. We used to have to learn poems. Bright star, would I were steadfast as thou art, not in lone splendor hung aloft the night, and watch it with eternal lids apart, like nature's patient, sleepless eremite.
John Keats.
In a sweet unrest, still, still to hear her tender taken breath, and so live ever, or else swoon to death. I love all that. Tender taken breath. The words are so pretty.
What's that?
What's it look like?
Where did you get it?
Borrowed it off a mate.
No, you didn't.
Cult peacemaker.
Don't point that thing at me.
It ain't loaded.
I don't care if it's loaded or not. Don't point it at me.
What are you doing, my girl?
I'm not your girl. You don't own me.
Yes, I do. It's yours, it's mine.
Go to hell, Jake.
Six. What do you reckon, eh?
How mad you are.
Yeah, maybe.
You haven't got the balls to do it, have you?
See, wouldn't have killed me. I reckon the odds are still the same. They don't change, do they? However many times you do it, it's always going to be 1 in 6.
There'll be a war, Mrs. Jackson. Boys might have to go and fight.
No one's leaving the farm.
He'd miss him if he had to go to war. Greg.
No one's going anywhere.
And Cain talked with Abel, his brother, and it came to pass when they were in the field that Cain rose up against Abel, his brother, and slew him. And the Lord said unto Cain, Where is Abel, thy brother? And he said, I know not. Am I my brother's keeper? And he said, What hast thou... I'll have that, thank you. In your pocket. What's in your pocket, Gregory?
Nothing.
Stand up. Empty your pockets.
Please.
Now. To the front.
Please.
Now.
Another one for you, Frank?
No, not for me. I've got work to do.
Work? This time of night?
You staying on for a few more then, are you?
You know me. Friday night, I'll be here for a while. I'll be seeing you then. I'll have another one. Who else is having one?
I shouldn't have asked, should I? Right, drinks all round. Come home safe, son.
God's sake, Greg. You're a farmer.
You'll be fine, Mother.
You know about fighting. There are plenty of young men who can go off and fight.
I can't stay here. Not now. I have to go.
If you let him go.
He's not a child no more. He can make up his own mind.
No, he can't. If you let my son go to war...
Our son.
Greg's mine. You had nothing to do with him. Jake's yours.
If you lot are the best our country can muster in its hour of crisis, God help the regiment and God help the country. And what have we got here? An horrible little Nancy boy. Let me make one thing abundantly clear. The only thing you'll be sticking up another man's arsehole is the bayonet attached to your Lee Enfield rifle. And the only recipient of such dubious pleasure will be Jerry. And he's not Jerry, are you?
No, sir.
And he's not Jerry either, are you?
No, sir.
No, sir, no, sir. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, sir.
Loud and clear!
Yes, sir.
Then stand up straight like a soldier, not a fucking Nancy boy.
I'm not a Nancy boy, sir.
Are you contradicting me, laddie?
No, sir.
What are you then?
A Nancy boy, sir.
Louder!
A Nancy boy, sir.
I want to hear what you are. Louder!
A Nancy boy, sir.
Not in my fucking army, you're not. If I so much as see you looking in the direction of another man's arsehole, I'll personally ensure you wish you hadn't been born. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, sir.
Do I make myself clear?
Yes, sir.
You lot, stop bloody smirking and move your arses. Or Mr. Nancy boy here will be poking something up there. Next two, on guard!
Tiger!
Next two, on guard!
On guard!
Next two, on guard!
Tiger!
Next two, on guard!
On guard!
Englander, come see here. We will take prisoners. Humsey.
Thank you.
does my breath smell?
No more than the rest of you. You're soft in the bleeding edge, you are.
Come on. Get your stuff together. We need to make a move.
Flax.
That's what the war ags say.
This is a dairy farm, Frank. I ain't never grown no flax before.
Use the seeds for linseed oil. Good for waterproofing and treating timber. It's all part of the war effort, as they say.
What about you, then? You going to be growing the stuff and all?
Don't you worry about me. I'm already doing my bit for king and country.
What if I says no, eh? What if I says they can stick their flax? What are these war rags going to do then, eh?
They got powers, they have.
Oh, yeah? And how come you know so much about it? How come you know so much about these war rags? You're one of them, ain't you, Frank? Not content with running your own farm, you have to go sticking your nose into other people's affairs.
Like I said, Jacob, I'm just doing my bit for England. I don't want to make things difficult between us. I've always been very fond of you and Margaret. I'm just in the middle of a great big chain, that's all. It gives me my orders. I just pass them on.
I know. It's just this bloody war. What with Jake as he is now and Greg gone.
Yeah, Margaret was beside herself. I spoke to Greg. I told him he didn't have to go. His mind was made up.
You told him that, did you?
Well, I knew just how much it would break Maggie's heart to have him gone.
Did you know? It was him, wasn't it? Frank. It was him.
It was a long time ago, Jacob.
Oh, I can do the adding up, Maggie. I can work out exactly how long ago it was.
Thank you.
Let's go, eh? Come on in.
Monsieur,
no. I am your friend. I bring you le petit déjeuner.
Voilà.
For you, English soldier. Eat. I am a miller. I make the flour, all my own work. Well, not quite. My daughter, she bakes the bread. Christabel. This is not a good place for you. The Germans are everywhere, like rats, vermin.
It's good. Thank you.
Ce sont les Anglais, de braves hommes. Ils nous aident contre les Allemands. She's very, timid.
Thanks, sweetheart.
We thought the French had all surrendered.
We're still bleeding from the last war, and the wounds are deep. But we do what we can. Some of us, anyway. We do our bit. But you must go when you've finished. If you head due north, you'll get to the coast. It's only about 20 kilometers from here.
And then? When we get there?
You have more chance of survival than you've got here.
And you?
I can take care of us.
Waffen auf den Boden!
Sehr gut.
Das Schwarzbrot wäre mir lieber.
Das ist nicht für euch.
Aber wir sind doch Ihre Gäste. Hm? Prost.
Ihr seid nicht eingeladen.
Wir wollen euch nichts Böses.
Aber wir werden hier bleiben. Also, gewöhnen Sie sich lieber daran, ja? Ist das hier Ihre Tochter? Ich habe Sie was gefragt, Monsieur. Ist das hier Ihre süße Tochter?
Wie alt?
Wie alt ist Ihre Tochter?
18.
18. Hm. Regarde.
Hey, wenn du fertig bist, bin ich dran.
Lass sie in Ruhe, Klaus. Sie ist zu jung.
Das will sie doch.
Wir sind hier in einer Kirche. Das ist ein Ort Gottes. Lass sie in Frieden.
Halt's Maul, Egon. Das ist eine kleine Franzosenhure. Du kommst auch gleich ran.
Sie ist eine Jungfrau.
Ja, du anscheinend ja auch.
Bastard!
Verzeihung! Verzeihung! Ihr seid in Frankreich willkommen. Aber bitte, lass meine Tochter in Ruhe. Sie ist alles, was ich habe. Hier, trink. Bitte schön.
Also jetzt sind wir Freunde, ja? Freunde. Dein Vater will, dass wir Freunde werden. Also, mach die Beine breit.
Ja, zeig ein richtiges deutsches Stück.
Nu!
Mach die Beine breit.
Lisla! Bastard!
Mach die Beine breit! Mach die Beine breit! Breiter! Breiter! Breiter!
Verdammte Schlampe!
Was habe ich getan?
Two points of the usual, Janet, love. Please. Just having a pint with my son, Frank. If that's all right with you. You don't have to stay if you don't want to. Not if you've got work to be doing. Fucking my wife.
Sorry. Easy does it. There you go. Must have a pint, innit? Good lad.
Where do you live? The mill. Where's the mill? Is it just you and...
See, wouldn't have killed me. Reckon the odds are still the same. They don't change, do they? But you're right. You're right, I haven't got the balls. But you have. You have.
You're mad. Why would I want to kill myself? Why?
Be fun. Come on, Greg. Come on, Greg. Do it for me. Come on. Do it for me, Greg. Do it for me. 6. Six. Go on, Greg. Do it with me. Do it with me, Greg.
Enlevez votre uniforme. Cachez-le. Si les Allemands le voient, ils...
My uniform. Of course.
Il y a des vêtements en haut. Ceux de... Ceux de mon père.
Yes. Thank you.
We have to do it. We have to go and do this to yourself, son. Flax. They want us to grow flax. What the fuck do they know? Fucking war axe. What do they know about farming? We don't need them, do we, son? We can run this fucking farm on our own, eh? Just the two of us. You and me, eh? What do you reckon, son? Don't call it a day. I'm so sorry, son.
I'm sorry. What's that?
Do it for me, Greg.
Thank you. How long have you been here at Semil?
Just over a week.
9 days, to be exact. Tu apprends très vite.
C'est un homme bien. Il prend soin de moi.
Oui, je sais. Burn your uniform, Gregory.
They're bringing a new Fordson tomorrow. Apparently this new model's a sight easier to start than the old one. Never did like those chilly mornings. Neither do I, for that matter. Flax is doing nicely, up in the top field. I thought you might like to know. You will tell me if you need anything, won't you, Maggie? Right then. I best be off. I'll see you tomorrow morning. All being well.
Thank you. Merci pour le pain.
Le pain.
Merci pour le pomme.
La pomme. Le pain masculin, la pomme féminin.
Comment c'est ça?
Non, vous êtes censé dire. Qu'est-ce?
Le caisse? La caisse.
C'est une bûche.
Une bûche. Caisse?
Un feu.
Un feu?
Oui.
Caisse?
Les flammes.
Les flammes. Caisse?
Votre cœur.
Votre cœur.
Votre cœur. Mon cœur.
Votre cœur. Mon cœur.
Oui, vous êtes un très bon élève.
Élève?
Élève. Étudiant, pupille.
Ah, pupille. Yeah, it's the same in English. Pupil. Caisse.
La bouche.
La bouche. La bouche, la bouche.
La bouche, c'est féminin. Féminin pour toi et féminin pour moi.
Caisse.
Mes lèvres.
Thank you.
It's lovely to get out.
It's not. More? Ain't fair. All of us girls. We can't do nothing about it. In the fresh air.
Christabel. J'ai senti un coup de pied.
Tu préférerais avoir un petit garçon ou une petite fille?
Une petite fille. J'aimerais avoir une petite fille.
Looks like you twisted your handlebars.
What about me?
Ain't nothing wrong with your handlebars, sweetheart. Here. Hey, look.
Your leg's bleeding.
Get your hands off me.
I'm medically trained, ma'am.
I don't care if you're a bloody surgeon. You're not touching me.
Okay, I'm sorry.
It's
It's my fault you fell off your bike.
I'll get your bike fixed up, free of charge.
And
I promise I'll never ever whistle again. Ever.
Ever, ever. Cross my heart.
Shut up.
Nice buns.
It's true what they say about you Americans, ain't it?
What do they say about us Americans?
Overpaid, oversexed, and over here.
That's harsh. We're not overpaid. I'm Sam. Sam Williams. You know, I played T-Bolt, the outfit of Stephen Warden. You ever been in a Thunderbolt? I could take for a spin if you like. Or maybe you'd like to come to the dance with me on Saturday, the town hall in Littleton. We'll go for a spin on the dance floor, if you prefer. Can you jitterbug? I could show you all the moves. Or maybe you got a few moves of your own you could show me.
Que voulez-vous?
Halt dein verdammtes Maul!
Hängen Sie mit?
Mit Vergnügen.
Wer ist das? Wer ist das?
Mon père!
Wo ist er?
Il est mort! Il est mort! Mon soeur, nous allons tuer il y a trois ans. Non, s'il vous plaît! Il est mort, s'il vous plaît!
Doch.
Dein Vater ist vor 3 Jahren gestorben, sagst du? Du hast also weitergemacht, wo er aufgehört hat. Er lebt hier mit dir.
Antworte ihm!
Antworte ihm!
Person! Person!
Und das? Unbefleckte Empfängnis? Englischer Soldat. Wo ist der? Wo ist er? Macht er mit? Ist er Teil von diesem Dreck? Wo ist er?
Je travaille tout seul.
Wo ist er? Du wirst mir jeden einzelnen Namen geben und glaub nicht, ich krieg das aus dir nicht raus. Bring sie runter.
Los!
Den kriegen wir später.
Ich hab Tor!
She's not here, you know she's not. Is this what you wanted? You have to be more careful, Greg. It's got all the name, all the codes, it's all in here. Is there anything else inside?
No.
Are you sure? I wouldn't go in there. There's explosives everywhere. I laid them earlier. Come, sweet. They're dogs. We need to move quickly. need to make more progress tonight before it gets light.
Where are you taking me?
Just outside Beauvais. It's about 50 kilometers from here.
Beauvais?
There's a plane dropping off a British agent. There will be space for you on the way back. You're going home.
This is my home now.
No. You can't stay in France. It's not safe for you. You know too much. It's not safe for any of us if you remain here. You have to leave.
Christabel.
Christabel is strong. Believe me. She is made of the same stuff as her father. She will be fine.
She needs me.
Listen, my friend. It's too late. Will all be over by now. There's nothing you can do. It's war, Greg. And war is not kind. Tu vas bien?
Ouais.
Also, die Namen
von jedem deiner Mitverschwörer. So gut. Krankenschwester!
Ja, natürlich.
Wir haben eine Krankenschwester hier, die dir helfen kann. Eine erfahrene Hebamme.
Zeit.
You were dead. You never wrote. Or anything. Not a word. How could you do that to me? My own son.
Do it for me, Greg. I've done it. We've done it, Greg. Greg, we've done it.
I'm so sorry, Jake. You didn't deserve any of this.
You are probably both wondering why I have chosen to tell you this story, and why I have spared you none of the unpleasant details. About 20 years ago, I made a shocking discovery. I was adopted as a young child. I came across the adoption papers purely by chance when both my parents were still alive. But they had brought me up with so much love that I could never bring myself to tell them that I had discovered the secret which they had decided to keep from me. But of course, curiosity is a very powerful thing. I wanted to find out more, and the more I found out, the more I needed to know. I was born in Abbeville in 1943 to a young French girl who had been captured by officers from the Sicherheitsdienst. Yes, of course, you realize now, don't you? Her name was Christabel. She died in labor in a basement of the town hall, which was being used to interrogate members of the French resistance. But I survived. And by a stroke of good fortune, I had blue eyes and blonde hair, a typical Aryan. So I was taken as part of the Nazi Lebensborn program. 6 months later, I was adopted by Wilhelm and Helga Gutenberg, your grandparents. Soon after Mama and Papa died, I decided to travel to England to find my birth father. By then, I already knew his name was Gregory Jackson. My journey took me all the way to Manor Farm. He was still there, farming the land, although he was frail and weak. Like Mama and Papa, he had carried the burden of his secrets throughout his life. He told me everything. His court-martial for desertion and the dark days he spent in prison for his brother's death. It all just poured out of him. He even took me into the barn to show me where he had ended Jake's life. I promised that I would go back and see him again, but as you know, my recent illness has been debilitating. I never made it back to England, so in a way, the story is incomplete. Gregory Jackson, your grandfather, grew old in the belief that brotherly love was just a fanciful notion which could never be a reality. There is a chance, a probability even, that he is now dead. But he may still be alive. Go and see him, will you? Go and show him that he has two wonderful grandsons who love each other the way brothers should. And tell him that you both made me his son, the proudest man who ever lived. Do it for him, will you? And for me. Finish the story.